you can win this 40 red Jeep on the turn of a single card on Card Shark. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Shark. Good morning to you. We're glad you're with us today. We are going to have a good time because we do have that great sporty red Jeep that Charley told you about to give away. Lots of money and two delightful card sharks. But before we get started with our game, I want you to meet our dealers. Here they come. They're with us every morning. Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams, our dealers on Card Shark. And good morning, ladies.
Good morning, Bob.
If you would please start dealing the cards out, because we're going to start fresh with a brand new guy. And you wait till you see this fella. He's a heck of a guy. Come on in here. Champion and challenger. Hello, Julie.
Hi.
This is our champion, Julie. And if you hear a little bit of an accent, it's a little bit of a Louisiana Cajun accent, right? And I love it. I think it's neat.
Oh, thank
you. Are there certain Cajun words that you can tell me about?
I don't know about on TV.
Those kind, yeah. Well, you're right. I never thought about that. Okay. But, tell me about Julie, then.
Well, my name's Julie Lambeau, and I'm originally from New Orleans, Louisiana. And I live here in California, and soon we'll be moving off to New Jersey with my husband's work.
What part of New Jersey?
Well, at first we'll be living in Seaside Heights, and then we're going to be going up to Bergenfield.
All right, fine.
Never been there, so I guess it'll be fun to see.
Good luck to you. You got $9,109 cash and prize, including a brand new car. And hello, Charley.
Hello, Bob. How are you, Bob?
Boy, do I ever like you, Charley.
Good.
You're my kind of guy. I like anybody that's got less hair than me.
But I don't have any gray hair.
You don't have any gray hair?
No.
What happened to it?
Well, if you really want to know the truth, I'll tell you the story.
Well, no, I don't want to know the truth.
Well, here's the story. My wife said, if I shaved my head,
yes,
she would give me a divorce. She lied.
She lied?
Yeah. Believe that she lied.
Does she like you better with a... Do you shave your head every day?
Yes.
Well, I bet that hurts.
No, it doesn't hurt. No.
Do you do it by yourself?
Well, I use my electric razor, but I also shine it after.
No kidding. What do you put on to make it shine?
Huh? Well, I use a balm. It's a tiger balm. And I get it in Chinatown.
Oh,
and
bomb.
It really makes you feel good. B-A-L-M.
B-O-M-B. I was going to say, that hurt, too. Tell me a little bit about Charley.
My name is Charley Goodman. I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York. And I've been living out here for 41 years. And I have a lovely wife and three children. And I'm a retired traveling salesman.
Well, okay. I could have guessed that myself. You know how to play this game, win two games, you're the champ. Let's get going right now. Susanna Williams is our dealer today. She's got the cards all dealt out, and we are on our way. First question, by the way, involves 10 single women who are living with their boyfriends, and they're going to be with us all week long to help us out. And Julie, the first question is yours.
Okay.
Come on, Ruth, get up there, kid. In case you weren't with us yesterday, Ruth is 85 years old. She's living with her boyfriend. And I love her. Okay, here we go, Julie. Before the show, we asked these 10 women, do you ever feel guilty about living out of wedlock? How many of these 10 women said sometimes they do feel guilty about living out of wedlock?
Oh, I tell you. They all look real happy, they don't seem like they're, you know, too guilty about it. They're having a good time. I would say it's going to be a low number. Maybe three of them.
Three, do you think? Charley, what do you think about this? You said three out of the 10 feel guilty about living out of wedlock. Higher or lower?
Well, I would say it would be lower. Because by today's standards, living together doesn't mean anything. When I was a young man, if I even went in the ladies' apartment, we started talking about it. So.
Boy, isn't that the truth?
Whoa.
Yeah. A long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Actual number of these women who sometimes feel guilty about living out of wedlock is four of them. Wasn't lower, a little bit higher. That's interesting. Which four of you ladies actually feel guilty? Raise your hand if you would, please. I see three. Oh, there's four. I'm sorry. Diane, why would you feel guilty? It's the choice you've made.
Well, my parents are always reminding me I'm not married. My father has a saying that he always tells me. He says, why buy the cow when you get the milk for free? So, you know, he's always there reminding me.
Let me write that down. I got to tell my daughter that one. Yeah. All right, ladies, thank you. Nice to have you with us. I like that saying, too. And it's true.
I've heard it before. Oh,
you've heard it before?
Yeah. Dad? I'm from Texas.
Oh, I see.
One of the old Southern expressions.
Julie, here we go. 10, play or change?
Change it.
Change it.
Okay.
Susanna's got a new one for you. There's a new one.
Oh, higher.
Is it higher? Heck yes.
Lower
than the 10. Charley, the rules say you get a free chance at the card, so you can't change it. You didn't win the question. It's a 6.
I'm going to go higher.
Hey, higher, is it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Lower.
Lower, the man says. Got it.
Higher.
Is it higher?
Nope. Oh. Son of a gun. There. Tell you what we'll do. We'll pause with these words and we'll be right back to find out who's going to win this game right after this.
There's so much going on in Cram.
Don't forget my Vita Ball.
Welcome back. Let's continue this match between Julie and Charlie now. No one has any kind of lead at all. Charlie, my friend, I've got a question for you. And you know what? This is an educated guess question. You may know something about this, but I'm not sure. On the average, Charlie, what percentage of plastic surgeons' patients are women? You ever had anything done, Charlie?
No, I have never had any plastic surgery done. However, I do know people who have had plastic surgery done.
Really?
And most of them have been women.
Is that right?
Right, it's correct. And I have a feeling that it's going to be a high percentage.
Excuse me just a moment. Get off of my face.
Was he referring
the director
to plastic
knows,
surgery?
The director knows that the dimple in my chin is my belly button.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
So what percentage of the plastic surgeon's patients do you think are women?
I would say 75% of the
75%.
Women.
75%. Let's see what Julie says. Higher or lower than 75?
I tell you, that's a good answer. I'll have to go maybe a little bit lower because I think some men maybe have had plastic surgery.
You don't think that would really happen, do you?
Listen,
actual percentage of plastic surgeons patients who are women is 88%. No, was it lower or was higher? Charlie has the control. All right, Charlie, want to change the six?
Change that card.
Okay. Well, we'll do it. Six becomes the eight.
Lower.
Going lower, yeah.
Lower.
Lower again, yeah.
Lower.
Lower, he's going on. No. Boy, you're going to be sorry about that one, aren't you? Yeah. Took a shot, he said. Those traveling salesmen, they're that way. Julie, here we go. Free
okay,
chance.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than the deuce. Nine's the card, babe.
Lower.
Lower, the lady says. No. Once again, we're right back to where we started, aren't we? Okay. What are you shaking hands for? Julie, here's one for you.
Okay.
You know, you often hear about a woman dating a man old enough to be her father. Well, we surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, have you ever dated a woman who was old enough to be your mother? I get Ruth up here. How many bachelors said they have dated a woman who was old enough to be their mother?
There's a lot of people. There's a lot of good-looking women, and you would not even believe their age, you know, that they could, for these younger than I know my brother. He comes in, he calls me up and tells me all kinds of wild stories. Oh, yeah, I'm seeing this one, seeing that one. And he's 20 years old, and the women he's seen, my goodness. I'll have to say.
Thanks for sharing that with us.
Yeah, well, that's, you know, all those people in New Orleans. I'm going to say.
How many bachelors have dated a woman old enough to be their mom?
37.
37 out of 100. Charlie.
Well, I'm going to say it's lower. Because I think the most of the time a bachelor dates a woman that way as old as his mother, to be old enough to be his mother, it's usually for a business luncheon, or just a good fellowship, a friendship, but for real,
or how about a little
for the
experience.
Real material experience, I think he's going to go lower. So
you think so?
Wrong with that old.
Is that right? Actual number of bachelors who have dated a woman who was old enough to be their mother is 20 of them. You're right, Charlie. One more. Charlie with the ace. Here we go.
Higher. I mean lower.
Lower. Yeah. Six.
Okay.
Can I change that?
No.
Huh?
No, you can't change.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher. Is it higher? No.
No. Uh-huh.
All right, Julie, son of a gun, here we go.
Here we go, higher.
Higher than the deuce, three.
Higher.
Higher than the three, deuce.
Oh.
I can't believe it. Charlie keeps rubbing his head. What are you rubbing your head for?
For luck.
That's luck?
Yeah.
So far it hasn't worked. I don't want you to know that.
I'm going
to
rub my...
We're going to play sudden death in just a moment. We're going to let Charlie rub his chest. We'll be back in just a moment. So don't go away.
And Pacific.
Welcome back. Time to play sudden death. Fourth and final question in the first game between our champion Julie and our challenger Charlie. Control is really what you're looking for, and Charlie, the question is yours.
Mm-hmm.
We surveyed 100 medical doctors. Another doctor question for you, Charlie. Mm-hmm. You did so well in the last one. Have you ever given yourself a shot? That's what we asked him. How many doctors have given themselves a shot?
Well, I'll have to tell you this much. I happen to have a friend of mine who's a doctor.
Yeah.
And he told me that every now and then when he gets him down or he needs to have a little help or cold or something, he always takes a shot. He gives himself a shot. And he thinks it's quite prevalent in the medical profession.
No
kidding. So I say it'll be about 65.
Huh. 65 out of 100 doctors have given themselves a shot. What do you think, Julie?
I think it's going to be just a little bit lower than that.
Think it might be lower?
Yeah, because I can
imagine how the heck they do that.
Yeah.
How do you do that? This won't hurt. Oh, yes, it will. Actual number of doctors who have given themselves a shot is 39.
Yeah.
A lot lower. Sudden death. What we're playing now. This is really an unusual situation, Julie, because you both have the best cards in the world. Now, sudden death, Julie, which means that you can play it out. If you goof, he wins the game, or pass it on to Charley. If he goofs, you win the game.
I'm gonna have to pass it.
You're pass it to Charley. Yeah, all right. Charley, here we go.
Lower
than the ace it is.
All right.
Higher.
Going higher. No, that means that Julie wins the game. Rub your head again, man.
I don't believe it.
I don't either. The most unusual card.
I don't believe it.
All right, so the first game goes to Julie. She gets another $100. That means that, Charley, you have to win this next game to stay in this match. Okay? First player to win two games is our champion, and Susanna's going to deal out the cards from the same deck. And let's get going with game number two right now. And, Julie, this is your question, and this question once again involves our 10 single women living with their boyfriends who are down there to help us out. Before the show, we asked these 10 single ladies, does your boyfriend do at least half the housework? How many of these 10 women said their boyfriend does at least half the housework?
Okay, well, since they're living together, I know that doesn't always make a difference. They probably help out a whole lot. I know my husband, you know, does. I'm going to have to say six of them.
Six out of the 10 of these women said their boyfriend does at least half the housework. Charley?
I would say it's higher.
Really?
Because everything today is a community property, community cohabitation, and I would say that they all work together. I would say they're higher.
I wonder if boyfriends will help more than husbands would help.
I
probably
think they
so,
would.
Because they have the threat of her walking out. I'll clean the house. Come back, dear. Or I won't clean the house. Get out, dear. The actual number of these women whose boyfriend does at least half the housework is 7 of them. Yeah, it was higher. I'm amazed at that. You 7 ladies, please raise your hand. Will you do that for me? Yeah. Christine, did you have any trouble getting him to do it?
No, he does more than half. He does 3/4 of it.
Well, on his own, he just goes and does that.
No, I have a list, and every day he has to do one thing. And if he doesn't do it, it carries on to the next day.
Oh, isn't that nice? Yeah, I think that's wonderful that you have a child to raise. I really do, Christy. Thank you, ladies, very much. Woo! She's a tough one a little bit. Charley? Rub it with both hands. That's what it needs, Charley. All right, here we go. All work.
Change it.
Yeah.
All right.
8 becomes 7.
A little higher.
We go higher than the 7. It is.
Yeah. Lower.
Lower. Yeah.
Lower.
Lower. Yeah.
Come on.
Player freeze, Charley.
Higher.
He's going on.
Higher.
He chooses not to freeze. If it's higher, he wins the game. Yeah. There you go.
Woo.
Okay. Now, we've tied it up. One game for each one of our contestants, which means now we must play the tiebreaker to find out who the champion is going to be. Susanna will deal out only 3 cards. I have only 3 high-low questions. This will determine who the champion is. Charley, question's yours. Surveyed 100 men who have a teenage daughter. We asked them, if your daughter were dating a boy who acted just like you used to at his age, would you trust him with your daughter? I'd lock her in the closet is what I would do. How many dads said they would trust their daughter with a boy who acted just like they used to?
Well, let me see now. I'm trying to think back when I was a young man, how I was.
You can only ask so much of yourself, Charley.
That's true. So I'm going to just generalize and say that I think about, 70 men.
70 out of the 100 men would trust
their daughter.
Their daughter with a boy who acted just like they did.
Just like they did.
Julie.
I would say 70 of them.
Lower, because when you get to be a dad, you change.
Boy, you do, don't you?
You do, yeah lower.
Probably minus 70.
Yeah.
Actual number of dads who would trust the boy who acted just like they did is 42.
Yeah.
Yes, it was lower. I'm surprised it wasn't even lower than that. All right, Julie, there's the card. It's
okay,
a jack.
Lower.
I go lower than that jack? No. Charley with a free chance, 3 cards away from winning this match. Let's see if you do. 9, can't change it.
Can't change it?
Nope, didn't want a question.
Lower
than the 9. It is.
Wow. Higher.
You're the new champ, Charley.
Woo.
Way to go, big Chuck. Julie, we say goodbye to you at $9,209 cash prize.
It's been wonderful.
Nice
I've had so
you.
Much fun. I really
good
have.
Good luck in your new home.
Oh, thank you.
Right over here, Charley.
All right. Congratulations to you, my friend.
We'll be back in just a moment to give this man a chance to win a whole lot of money and a brand new car.
Bigger. Badder. Redder. Plank.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. Charley is our champion now. We're excited for you, my friend, because this is the time where you can win a whole lot of money, and we got a Jeep back there, and you can ride with the top down, not mess up your hair. I just think it's wonderful. In addition to all the money you can win, and we've added a couple of jokers to the deck. Every time a joker comes up, gives you a chance of winning that Jeep. Also, I will remind you, you can change one card per line, and because you are the champ, Susanna's got one joker for you, so you know you at least have one opportunity of winning that new car. We're rooting for you. We want you to win. Give him $200. Let's see what he can do. Here we go. All right, Charley, you got $200 in your first card. Is a six, you can play or change.
Change it.
Which one do you want?
One.
Number one. Let's see what we got. Lacey's got a new one for you. The six becomes a six. $200.
$100 higher.
$100 higher than the six. You got $300.
I got $300. $200 lower.
$200 lower than the queen. Now, you got $500 you can't change.
I can't change the eight, right?
No, there's only one card per line.
I got $500.
$500.
$500. All right, $200 lower.
$200. Lower than the eight. No, that's all right. You're in fine shape.
Hey.
Yeah, you got three. Come up here, give you four. You got $700.
$700 lower.
All of it lower. There you go. $1,400.
Five. Change to five.
Change to five.
What
will it be? Here we go. Five is Jack.
Okay.
A little bit better. $1,400.
I'll take $700 lower.
$700 lower than the jack. No. Okay, got an ace. Let's go back.
Okay. $700 higher.
No, not higher.
I mean lower.
Yeah. All of it lower. Now we go. $1,400. Come up here. You got a four. You got to bet at least $700, Charlie.
I'm going to go.
You can change the card if you want.
Change it?
Yeah.
Change it.
Sure, you got another card. You can change the four. See what he comes up with this time. That's
okay.
Better.
All of it.
All of it.
Higher.
All of it higher. Could be worth $2,800.
The big one.
Yeah, that's the big one, all right. Ugly. Ugly. I just threw it at Susanna because you're mad at it. Step right over here. Would you step right over here for me, pal? I didn't mean to hit you with that ugly card, but that
okay.
Was
it wasn't
poor
ugly
Charley.
Card.
Yeah, we just wiped him out. Yeah. Charley, we want you to win the car now.
Okay,
and here's how you can do that. I want you to take a look over here for me. Seven cards. Behind one of them is the word car. You find it, and you win the Jeep. Charley?
The Wrangler from Jeep Corporation offers both on- and off-road driving in comfort. The Wrangler comes with Sport Decor Group and California Emission.
Okay, Charley. Boy, that was real tough. Now, let's go win a car.
Okay.
Any idea where to put that thing? Number two, the man says. You come right back over here. Boy, I hope you win it. I really do. Boy, I'm still in shock about that. All right, if the word car is back here, then you got yourself a new Jeep. Boy, would we like to see you win the car. Is it behind number two? There! You can get up there. You're not too old. Go ahead.
Woo!
Hey, if you see this guy coming down the road, you know it's car charge. $11,965 in tax and prices, and we'll be right back.
Of course. Hey, I got to take the car, so it's $1,400. That's wonderful. I appreciate it. Great.
Other country. I guess the old saying goes, you know, what goes around comes around. You have bad luck, and then you have good luck. I was feeling so bad for you when you had the three, bet everything he owned, and ends up with a two. That was wonderful. But then you step over there and win that new car. Isn't that fun?
Great. Fantastic.
Right. We don't have any time to meet a new challenger for today. Will you come back tomorrow?
I certainly will.
Somehow I knew you would. I really did think that. We certainly hope that you'll come back next time, too. For Susanna Williams, Lacey Pemberton, Charley O'Donnell, who's with us this week, I'm Bob Eubanks saying thank you very much for watching Card Sharks. We'll all see you next time. Bye-bye.
There's never been anything.
Followed by Match Game.
Cram contestants have 24 hours to fill their heads with facts. Host Graham Elwood crams his show into 30 minutes. They all could use a good night's sleep.
It's called sleep deprivation, and it's sweeping across the nation.
Stay up and watch Cram tonight at 11 Eastern and Pacific, only on Game Show Network.